اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إذا الشمس كورت وإذا النجوم انكدرت وإذا الجبال سيرت وإذا العشار عطلت وإذا الوحوش حشرت وإذا البحار سجرت وإذا النفوس زوجت وإذا الموءودة سئلت وإذا الموءودة سئلت بأي ذنب قتلت وإذا الصحف نشرت وإذا السماء كشطت وإذا الجحيم سعرت وإذا الجنة أزلفت علمت نفس ما أحضرت فلا أقسم بالخنس الجوار الكنس والليل إذا عسعس والصبح إذا تنفس إنه لقول رسول كريم ذي قوة عند ذي العرش مكين مطاع ثم أمين وما صاحبكم بمجنون ولقد رآه بالأفق المبين وما هو على الغيب بضنين وما هو بقول شيطان رجيم فأين تذهبون إن هو إلا ذكر للعالمين لمن شاء منكم أن يستقيم وما تشاءون إلا أن يشاء الله إلا أن يشاء الله رب العالمين آمنا بالله صدق الله العلي العظيم صلوا على محمد وآل محمد. Please recite another salawat. Assalamu alaikum, everyone. Condolences to you on these days of Wafat al-Nabi and Shahadat of Imam Hassan alayhi salam. The program today is a lecture from the Sayyid, followed by Matam and some refreshments at the end. I'd like to thank you for your continued support for fundraising. We've raised around £1,500, and our target was £2,000, so thank you so much for your generous donations. We are looking for volunteers, so if you are able to help with this project, we're always looking for people to support us. So if you'd like to give your name to one of us and your contact details, it'd be great to have you on board as part of our team. As a brief introduction to the Sayyid for those who weren't here yesterday, Sayyid's full name is Dr. Sayyid Ja'far Fadlullah. He is the son of Grand Ayatollah Sayyid Muhammad Hussein Fadlullah. He's currently undertaking a visiting research fellowship at Al Mahdi Institute in Birmingham. He has a master's in and a PhD in sociology. And he's been a lecturer of jurisprudence in Lebanon since 1999. Yesterday, the Sayyid spoke on how to fulfill justice in our life. And he gave us several important learning points. One of them was that we should live with affection and mercy amongst ourselves and our family lives, and we should do without expecting in return. Today he will be speaking about the image of the Prophet in the Holy Quran. So if we could please welcome him with a loud salawat.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين وأصحابه المنتجبين وعلى جميع الأنبياء والمرسلين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Why are we searching for the image of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam in the Quran in particular? Why don't we search for this image in the Hadith? And we have to deal with all the sources of this image of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam. But as we concentrating tonight on the image of the Prophet in the Quran, we have to ask ourselves this question: why are we concentrating on this image in the Quran in particular? And one may ask also, why should we be attached to the history? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam was a messenger, and there were many messengers who passed away. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states in the Quran, وَمَا مُحَمَّدٌ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ الرُّسُلُ. Muhammad is only a messenger, and many messengers has gone before him. So why should we be attached to this history? Shouldn't we fulfill or apply the teachings of Quran to our lives? And this is enough for us. This is the duty that we have. Maybe some Muslims will say, what we are doing today or nowadays in this meetings to remember this history, it's something out of Islam. So here also we have to ask ourselves this question in order to have answers, and then we can argue about this, those actions or those, you know, meetings. To answer this, we have to point on some or three points in particular. First, why should, in answering this question, I will repeat, why should we searching, why should we be, or should we search this image in the Quran Kareem in particular? We have here three points, and those three points together will give us the answer of this question. The first point is that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the perfect representative of the Quran. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the perfect representative of the Quran. So as we come to learn his image from the Quran, we will be face to face with the image of the perfect Muslim, because Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam is the first Muslim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Quran, وَأُمِرْتُ لِأَنْ أَكُونَ أَوَّلَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ, and I am commanded that I shall be the first of those who submit, or those Muslims. So when we learn this image from Quran, we are learning the image of the perfect Muslim. This is a very important point. And this will be the fastest way to know the meanings of the verses of Quran. And this, in fact, this is the way how the first Muslims, the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, had known the meanings of Quran. They had only to listen to Rasulullah reciting the verse of Quran that is revealed to him, and then they will see the meaning of this verse in his act. They will see the meaning of this verse in his spiritual expressions. They will see the meaning of the verse in his attitudes, in his stance. So this is the first point. The second point we have now, it's a very critical in our life today. We have many acts of terrorism, and those extremists who are labeling Islamic movements or something like that, they are those people, or such people, such Muslims, they are indirectly constructing another image of the Muslim, and they are giving to the others, even to Muslims. Now we all Muslims, we may, if we ask our children, what's the image of Rasulullah? When they see what those such Muslims are doing or acting in the name of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they will be confused. What is that image, or what that image is? So the terrorist acts that the extremists commit indirectly construct an image of the Muslim person. And we cannot rely on people that we say they should distinguish between the Islam and such acts. The average people has not the ability to do this. So we cannot rely on this. They will have this image of Islam, this image of Muslim, from the media. And we can see that impact about many, the mind of the world. So they also construct a false image of the Prophet as well, because they are committing such acts in his name and promoting the notion that they are fulfilling his orders and applying his sunnah, as they say. This will bind his name, the Prophet's name, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to those actions in the mind of the people of the world. The third point here, as we are answering the main question, why should we search this image in the Quran, is that this image, which is learned from the Quran Kareem, has the authenticity with respect to the image that can be derived from the Hadith. And this is, I think, we have to stop here to make this point very clear. The Quran, as we all believe, the Quran is correct. The Quran is wholly true. And the Quran, wherein exists no minute mistake in the Quran. We cannot find any minute mistake in the verses of Quran. No words, there is no word added, nowhere, you know, we cannot say that the Quran is not that which revealed to the heart of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, and the Quran is the word of Allah, as we believe. So the image that we can derive from Quran is the image that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to have of this Prophet. So we are talking about an authentic source. That this point differs when we are talking about the Hadith. This aspect does not hold true for the Hadith, because you know the Hadith is the narrations of men, and they are affected by many factors, maybe social, maybe psychological, maybe political. We have many impacts here on the Hadith that we do not have on the Quran. So as we comparing between these two sources, we say that we are searching for the image of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam from the Quran, because we want to have a very correct or a precise image. And we see here, nowadays, we see how such Muslims who are the extremists, what image they are giving us, because they relied actually on some Hadith or some riwayat, some narrations they relied on, and they derived this image that the Muslim must be a killer. The Muslim must be seeking of bloodshedding. We can see this image. This image is not out of our, you know, traditions, narrations. So we have to make this image very, very correct, very precise. So this is the reason that we are searching for the image of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam from the Holy Quran. So, and let me say something here about the relationship between the relation between the Hadith and the verses of Quran. The Quran is the balance of the Hadith. Even if we have a Sahih Hadith which has a valid chain, Sanad Sahih, if we compare this Hadith to the verses of Quran, and we see here that this Hadith in its content contradicts the content of the verses of Quran, then we have to neglect this hadith, even if its chain is sahih. This is the whole ulama will say that. So here we are talking about a very special source. When we are deriving the image of Rasulullah from Quran, so we will have this very correct and very precise image of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So the Quran is considered as the balance, or the base of balance of any knowledge of Islam, any knowledge, doctrine, jurisprudence, concepts, methods, moral values, etc. All the knowledge that we must gain or have or derive must be balanced by this base of balance, which is the Quran Kareem, that unfortunately we don't depend on. So we have many confused or many ambiguous in many concepts and in many fields of knowledge of Islam. Allow me to now to purpose on a following example. We have a certain hadith that discourages marrying Kurdish people and or people of color. We have this certain hadith. As a result, many jurists relied on this hadith and say that as they were developing their fatwa, so they have this fatwa that the marrying from Kurdish or Kurds or people of color is discouraged, makruh. They said that. Some others say that this is not correct. We cannot accept this kind of hadith because this contradicts the Quran Kareem. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in his book, and we have certainly honored the children of Adam, وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي Adam, as human beings, not as a specified, you know, nationalities or colors or etc. We have honored all the human beings as they are human beings. And also Allah says in Quran, indeed the most noble of you in the sight of Allah is the most righteous of you. Inna akramakum 'inda Allahi atqakum. This is what Allah says in Quran. So this hadith, even if it has a valid chain or sahih, sanad sahih, this hadith can be easily neglected because it contradicts the Quran. Every knowledge that we have to make it related to Islam must be balanced on this Quran Kareem. So because of that, all of that, these three points will give us the answer. Why are we searching for the image of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wa sallam in the Holy Quran? So, returning to the image of the Prophet, I have here to try to clarify the core of our relationship with the Prophet. Because when we derive this image of the Prophet from Quran Kareem, then we have to know what is the relationship between us as we live in the 15th century or the 2017, or, you know, and this image is derived from the past. Rasulullah lived in a certain time, in a certain place, and there are many circumstances that maybe we do not have now. So what is the core of this relationship according to the Quran Kareem itself? We have this verse of Quran Kareem, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُ اللَّهَ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرُ وَذَكَرَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. This is the core, الْأُسْوَة. There has certainly been for you in the Messenger of Allah an excellent pattern or a role model for anyone whose hope is in Allah and the last day and who remembers Allah often. This is the verse of Quran Kareem, sets the core of our relationship with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But the question here is, how can we know a certain behavior of the Prophet as a role model for us? Is it related to the absolute behavior, regardless of the time and the place and the traditions, culture between the past and the present? Is it related to the absolute behavior, the shape that we can see at that time? We derive or take that shape and we apply it to our life. This is it. Some Muslims, they deal with the sunnah of Rasulullah like this. They have short dresses. They have long beard. They have, because they are applying the sunnah. They say such things. This is, will make this uswa related to the absolute behavior, the shape of the behavior of Rasulullah. So we are here neglecting the role of time and place and cultures, that we know that it varies among the time. We know that. But how can we prove this from Quran Kareem? As we said before, the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the perfect representative of Quran. So when we have to know his behavior as a sunnah, we have to refer to the root that the Quran gives us. Why Rasulullah is acting like this? Why is he dressing like this? As if we suppose that is true, that Rasulullah has this long beard, you know. We can argue on that. Because مَا زَادَ عَلَى الْقَبْضَ فَهُوَ فِي النَّارِ. You cannot make your beard out of this length. As a tradition, maybe if of that time. So here we must refer to the to the Quran, to know the root. Rasulullah sallallahu Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Quran, Ya Bani Adama, خذوا زينتكم عند كل مسجد. يا بني آدم خذوا زينتكم عند كل مسجد. O children of Adam, take your adornment at every masjid. So the custom reflects a certain adornment. This is the title. We derive this title from Quran. So we see that when Rasulullah was dressing in a certain way, or his appearance was in a certain shape, so he was applying this title, this concept. It's an adornment, and we know that this varies. This will be different among the time, the places, traditions, cultures. As Imam Sadiq alayhi salam explained that, Imam Sadiq says, خَيْرُ لِبَاسِ الزَّمَانِ لِبَاسُ أَهْلِ خَيْرُ لِبَاسِ الزَّمَانِ لِبَاسُ أَهْلِ. The best dress of a certain time is the dress of that time. So this is how Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam explains the sunnah. And this is why we are followers of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam, because we will know, we will be well known of the sunnah when returning to those hadith of Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam. So because of that, one couldn't claim that it is sunnah to wear a short dress or to grow out your beard to extreme length and thickness, or thicknesses. Because the Prophet supposedly did that, even if it was in fact that he did. We cannot, because we have to go to the root. why Rasulullah was doing that, if we suppose that it is true. The prophet's behavior or custom should be related to the base of action in Islam and then be balanced by the ways and the traits of a given, of the givens of real life. So we have to, when we take that title or that concept, we can take this concept to our life, and then we have to apply this concept as we have in our life, as maybe customs or ways or traits, etc. Another verse that will draw the image of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states, لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مِّنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ عَزِيزٌ عَلَيْهِ مَا عَنِتُّمْ حَرِيصٌ عَلَيْكُمْ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَؤُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ. There has certainly come to you a messenger from among yourselves. Grievous to him is what you suffer. He is concerned over you, and to the believers is kind and merciful. This is an image of Rasulullah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states in his Quran. In this verse, we have many points. First, the messenger is from amongst yourselves. He is not out of the human, of humanity. He is among human beings. He is one of them. So because of that, he will be aware of how they feel. He will be aware of what they need. He will be aware of what they benefit from. He will be aware of their strengths or weaknesses. This is because he is one of them. So his feelings is not out. He is not a being out of humanity. He is a human being. Basharun mithlukum. He is one of those. One amongst yourself, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. The second point here from this verse of Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the Prophet is as sensitive as would be your father. عَزِيزٌ عَلَيْهِ مَا عَنِتُّمْ. His heart engulfs your pain. His soul encompasses your anxiety. His eyes follows your steps, observing your achievements and developments. This is how Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was. Also, he is merciful towards the believers because he is not so different from them. He knows their weaknesses, so he does not overload them, but raises them gradually. He will forgive their slips, their sins. And this is what Rasulullah was dealing with the mistakes that the believers were committing in many ways. The third verse that we have to learn from it here, وَمِنْهُمُ الَّذِينَ يُؤْذُونَ النَّبِيَّ وَيَقُولُونَ هُوَ أُذُنٌ قُلْ أُذُنُ خَيْرٍ لَكُمْ يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَيُؤْمِنُ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ. And among them are those who abuse the Prophet and say, he is an ear, because he listens to everybody. And someone may come in the morning and say something that contradicts what he says in the evening. And Rasulullah will say, Barakallahu feek, in the morning and in the evening. So maybe some people thought that Rasulullah is a naive. No, this is a mercifulness. Rasulullah was not a naive. He was merciful. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, who abused the Prophet and say he is an ear, say it is an ear of goodness for you that believes in Allah and believes the believers and is a mercy to those who believe among you, and those who abuse the Messenger of Allah for them is a painful punishment. So he is an ear of goodness. He is an ear of goodness. He is a leader. As Rasulullah is a leader, the leader is ready to listen to his followers' speech. He will listen for them because the act of listening is something that is very useful for them as followers. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will listen to everything that they will say to him, even if they are saying contradictions. Because, you know, this is a kind of mercifulness that alleviates insecurities and raises self-esteem and self-assurance. We know very well that just the act of expression by a given individual plays a role in many things, plays a role in releasing anxiety. Only just the act of expression, releasing anxiety, relieving one's insecurities, raising confidence, allowing for self-discovery, purification of his soul, and even elevating levels. This is what Rasulullah was doing when he was listening to those. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in this verse, he is an ear of goodness for you, and is a mercy to those who believe among you. Is a mercy, Rasulullah. This is a mercifulness. We have here the third or maybe the fourth, I don't know. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says here, هو الذي بعث في الأميين رسولا منهم يتلو عليهم آياته ويزكيهم ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة وإن كانوا من قبل لفي ضلال مبين. This is in Surah Al-Jumu'ah, the second ayah of Surah Al-Jumu'ah. We repeat this every Friday in Salat. But I think this is a very important verse that maybe will be a base of evaluation of any spiritual leaders or any scholars that we have to deal with. We have to make evaluation according to this verse of Quran Kareem. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us the real meaning of, or the real role of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we as scholars, we have to depend on this image of Rasulullah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives to us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, it is he who has sent among the unlettered a messenger from themselves. This concentrating on themselves, from themselves. He is not out of earth. He is not from another planet. From among themselves, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, reciting to them his verses and purifying them and teaching them the book and wisdom, although they were before in clear error. I have to concentrate here on three things mentioned in this verse. First, purifying them. Rasulullah has this role, purifying the believers. As the Prophet has the role of purifying people, then he must be the embodiment of purity in his spirituality and mannerisms. Because he who lacks something does not have the ability to give it to others. So Rasulullah must have this level of purity. Giving here is not giving, when we say Rasulullah will give or will purify, it's not that he will give them the theory of spirituality or ideal manners, but the influence of Rasulullah on others to both feel his purity and try to emulate it in their lives. This is about the purifying, the first point. Second, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Rasulullah teaches or teaching them. Rasulullah teaches them the book, which is the Quran. And maybe wider than, or relying on Quran, but he teaches them the how to think in their lives, relying on the book. The Prophet is not a speaker, and the Prophet is not a postman who delivers the message of Allah to humans only. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the perfect teacher who perfectly embodies and knows the book, and he teaches to the believers, and they will, relying on the Quran, they will know how to think in their lives and how to develop knowledge that they have from Quran. Third, teaching them wisdom. The Prophet does not simply teach the theoretical ways of the books, of the book, nor religious theories, only teaching theories. No, it's not this his role. He will teach how to apply these theories to our lives. This is wisdom. When you apply a certain idea in an appropriate way, in the suitable place and time, this is wisdom. So Rasulullah will teach the believers the wisdom. There are more and more verses that reflect the true image of the Prophet, and some of them have an indirect reflection, such as those which establish the principles of war in Islam. We have this ayah, وَقَاتِلُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ الَّذِينَ يُقَاتِلُونَكُمْ وَلَا تَعْتَدُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الْمُعْتَدِينَ. This is not a verse that talks about the image of Rasulullah directly. It talks about the image of Rasulullah indirectly. Does Rasulullah have a peaceful attitude? Or he is a warrior? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, fight in the way of Allah those who fight you, but do not transgress. Indeed, Allah does not like transgressors. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, would teach them how to apply this verse, because he teaches them the book and wisdom. So he will teach them how to apply this verse in their war, so that they would reflect particular manner of Islam that does not call for war for the sake of bloodshedding, revenge, or for war desires. Also, the teachings dictate that they do not initiate the fighting. We see that among all the wars that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Ahlul Bayt was in, they do not initiate the war, the fighting, but wait in defense against transgressors. And the Prophet is the first to apply these principles. Finally, I hope that the presentation has somehow shed light on this, on a side, only a side, because we must have, if we want to draw and to learn the image of Rasulullah among all the Quran, this requires hours upon hours. We do not have that time. So this is, but we tried here to have this a path of how can we deal with the image of Rasulullah, or how can we think about it or search about it. On a side of the image of the Prophet in the Quran, and examined how important to learn this image from the Quran, especially in our critical period that many of us or our fourth generations may have an ambiguous or distorted image of their Prophet and therefore image of their Islam. And I think the more we are learning, or we are learning about our Islam, the concept of Islam, the aqidah of Islam, the sharia of Islam, the more we are learning about this, the closer we are to the Prophet. This is what we have tried yesterday when we were talking about how to fulfill justice in our life. Because as we know how to fulfill justice in our lives, then we are closer to the teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So yesterday we were talking indirectly about our Prophet, because we were talking directly about our Islam, and our relationship with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was this Islam, to give us the clear Islam, the pure Islam, the original Islam. But we have to pay effort for that. We have to make researches. We have to learn about this. We have to have a very appropriate methodology when we want now to deal with our Islam. We cannot rely on what we see in our lives, a certain, a very ambiguous or distorted image that we see in our lives here in the name of Islam and in the name of Rasulullah. This is what we have tried yesterday, and this is what we have tried today. Thank you very much. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Brothers, get ready for Latum Jazakum Allah Khair al Jaza. عظم الله الأجر يا فاطمة عظم الله الأجر يا فاطمة عظم الله الأجر عظم الله الأجر يا فاطمة 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 عظم
Louder, brothers, come forward please, come forward and join in the عزاء, and I want your voices to be heard tonight.
عظم الله الأجر يا فاطمة عظم الله الأجر يا فاطمة عظم الله الأجر يا فاطمة عظم
MashaAllah, brothers, louders.
عظم الله الأجر يا فاطمة 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 عظم
With my hand, brothers, MashaAllah.
ما عظم الله الأجر يا فاطمة عظم الله الأجر طيما عظم الله الأجر يا فاطمة عظم الله
louder ما شاء الله
الله حجاب غيب الموت غرة والدك حجاب غيب الموت غرة والدك وعلى حمل الفرقة الله يساعدك وعلى حمل الفرقة الله يساعدك بس يا زهرة نريد بالله ناشدك بس يا زهرة نريد بالله ناشدك يا مصيبة خلاف عنا يا زهرة يا مصيبة خلاف عنا يا زهرة يا هضم يقع علينا يا زهرة وش تسوي الدنيا بينا يا زهرة وش تسوي الدنيا بينا يا زهرة ندري بالباب المحن متزاحمة عظم الله الأجر طيما عظم الله الأجر ما عظم الله الأجر There exists a love born before we're born. There exists a love born before we're born. Love for Muhammad in our heart is one. Love for Muhammad in our heart is one. It sleeps in our blood if from it we're torn. It sleeps in our blood if from it we're torn. Left in your absence forever we'd mourn. Left in your absence forever we'd mourn. Oh Father, how can such a love, ya Zahra? Oh Father, how can such a love, ya Zahra? So entrenched within our blood, ya Zahra, be torn away from the same blood, ya Zahra. I watch it down my cheeks flood, ya Zahra. Nidri bil babil mihan mitzahima, azzam Allah al ajr. عظم الله الأجر ما شاء الله louder عظم الله الأجر حل علينا الموت بثياب الحزن حل علينا الموت بثياب الحزن لخادم أهل البيت عمر فاروق البدراوي حل علينا الموت بثياب الحزن حل علينا الموت بثياب الحزن مستحي ودمعا ذبح فوق الجفن مستحي ودمعا ذبح فوق الجفن روح ابوك يريد ياخذها لكن روح ابوك يريد ياخذها لكن شاف حماي الحمية يا زهر ما شاء الله شاف حماي الحمية يخاف بس قلش بيدي يا زهراء مكتفي بحبل الوصية إيه مكتفي بحبل الوصية لا تخاف الباري أمرك حاسمة عظم الله الأجر يا فاطمة فاطمة عظم الله الأجر I feel the sunset deep within my heart. I feel the sunset deep within my heart. Poem is by Nuri Sardar. I feel the sunset deep within my heart. I feel the sunset deep within my heart. As if from my days, O Father, I part. As if from my days, O Father, I part. Our love like a day, beautiful it starts. Our love like a day, beautiful it starts. And yet it sunset tears this day apart. And yet it sunset tears the day apart. Our hearts were one, oh my father, ya Zahra. Our hearts were one, oh my father, ya Zahra. Today one half was stolen, ya Zahra. And by your absence the other, ya Zahra. And by your absence the other, ya Zahra. Is left shattered and broken, ya Zahra. Nidri bil babil mihan mitzahima. Azzam Allah al-ajr, ya Fatima. Azzam Allah al-ajr, ya Fatima. Azzam Allah al-ajr, ya Fatima.
نوحي يا زهرة أمر الله جرأ نوحي يا زهرة أمر الله جرأ نار قلبك خلتي ظل متوجرة نار قلبك خلتي ظل متوجرة حيدر بفقد النبي شي صابرة حيدر بفقد النبي شي صابرة شان قلب اليوم صابر يا زهرة شان قلب اليوم صابر يا زهرة بالمصيبة شلون باكر يا زهراء لو يشوف البيج صاير يا زهراء ما شاء الله لو يشوف البيج صاير هم ويا من يا زهراء يقسمه عظم الله عظم الله طيما عظم الله الأجر You became the best of all creation. You became the best of all creation. And your absence has broken a nation. You became the best of all creation. And your absence has broken a nation. But I swear the grief and lamentation. But I swear the grief and lamentation does not equal mine or my affliction. Does not equal mine. Or Oh, my affliction, if my grief were poured onto skies, ya Zahra. MashaAllah, louder, if my grief were poured onto skies, I'd see seven skies shatter. And in your absence, O Father, no sun or stars would matter. ندري بالباب المحن متزاحمة عظم الله الأجر يا فاطمة عظم الله الأجر ما عظم الله الأجر الكون كل الضيم قلبك يندفع الكون كل الضيم قلبك من جفع تنعويك السماوات السبع تنعويك السماوات السبع مو على الهادي علم صاب الضلع مو على الهادي علم صاب الضلع اليوم نعش الهادي وحدة يا زهراء اليوم نعش الهادي وحدة يا زهراء بس علي المفجوع عنده يا زهراء شراح يحصل بيك بعده يا شراح يحصل بيك بعده الله يعلم بالمصيبة القادمة عظم الله الأجر فاطمة عظم الله الأجر يا فاطمة Whatever begins ends eventually. Whatever begins ends eventually. And there are deaths in every family. But none have had you, you touch so beautifully. But none have had you, you touch beautifully. Let all die, just leave Muhammad only. I wish the world would break into Ya Zahra and take away everything, Ya Zahra. For it would be a better, Ya Zahra, if only you were living, Ya Zahra. لا تخاف الباري أمرك حاسمة عظم الله يا فاطمة عظم الله الأجر عظم الله الأجر يا فاطمة عظم الله الأجر I cry out a scream, come back Muhammad. I cry out a scream, come back Muhammad. I cry out a scream, come back Muhammad. For I see fire to our houses led. For I see fire to our houses led. And I see ashes covering my head. And I see ashes covering my head. From my nails piece I see blood has bled. head. From my nail's piece I see blood has it bled. I cry out a scream, come back Muhammad. I cry out a scream, come back Muhammad. For I see fire to our houses led. And I see ashes covering my head. And I see ashes covering my head. From a nail's piece I see blood has it bled. I feel torture, none have felt, Ya Zahra. I feel torture, none have felt, Ya Zahra. And toward your grave I turn, Ya Zahra. Along with my door and heart, Ya Zahra. I watch my love for you burn, Ya Zahra. الله يعلم بالمصيبة القادمة عظم الله الأجر يا فاطمة 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 عظم There exists a love born before we're born. There exists a love born before we're born. Love for Muhammad in our hearts is one. Love for Muhammad in our hearts is one. It sleeps in our blood if from it we're torn. It sleeps in our blood if from it we're torn. Left in your absence forever we'd mourn. Left in your absence forever we'd mourn. Oh Father, how can such a love, Ya Zahra, so entrenched within our blood, Ya Zahra, be torn away from the same blood, Ya Zahra. I watch it down my cheeks flood, Ya Zahra. Nidri bil babil mihan mitzahima, azzam Allah al-ajr. فاطمة عظم الله الأجر يا 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 فاطمة عظم الله الأجر فاطمة صوتك
عظم الله الأجر يا فاطمة أحسنتم عظم الله أجركم جميعا لشفاء المرضى ولقضاء الحوائج الآية المباركة جميعا بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم أمن يجيب المضطر إذا دعاه ويكشف السوء أمن يجيب المضطر إذا دعاه أمن يجيب المضطر إذا دعاه ويكشف السوء أمن يجيب المضطر إذا دعاه ويكشف السوء بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اللهم كن لوليك الحجة ابن الحسن صلواتك عليه وعلى آبائه في هذه الساعة وفي كل ساعة وليا وحافظا وقائدا وناصرا ودليلا وعينا حتى تسكنه أرضك طوعا وتمتعه فيها طويلا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين ولأرواح جميع المؤمنين والمؤمنات نهدي للجميع ثواب سورة المباركة الفاتحة تسبقها الصلاة على محمد وآل محمد
Thank you everybody for attending. We'd just like to, on behalf of IUS, we'd like to thank the Sayyid for coming to deliver these two nights of lectures. And we'd like to thank Abbas as well also for reciting Latam. So please could you recite a salawat. And we thank them greatly. Some light refreshments will be served at the back. And thank you again, everybody, for attending.